yeshiva of Madrigas HaOdom in Hillcrest, and he's the Rav of the Torah Center in Hillcrest as well. He told me a number of years ago, he got a call 3 o'clock in the morning. Now you know when your phone rings 3 o'clock in the morning, by the time you pick it up, you think it's been ringing 10 times. You're just so frightened. Who is calling 3 o'clock in the morning? And he picks up the phone, and this lady says, "Rabbi, is this Rabbi Faskowitz?" And he says, "Yes." She says, "Please, please excuse me for calling you so early in the morning, but I've been looking for you for the last 3 hours. He says, "Excuse me, who are you?" She says, "I don't know if you're going to remember me from about 10 years ago, but my name is Mrs. Flanagan." And he's thinking, who is Mrs. Flanagan? Like an Irish name, why would a woman be calling a rabbi 3 o'clock in the morning? And he's trying to remember. Oy vey. He says, "Are you that lady from the store on Ralph Avenue?" She says, "Rabbi, yeah, that's me." And he remembers an incident that happened 10 years earlier. Rabbi Faskowitz used to be a rove in Canarsie. And one day he was driving on Ralph Avenue, and there was a tremendous rainstorm and sleet. It was awful. And as he's passing this huge kosher supermarket on Ralph Avenue, he sees an elderly woman. She's standing under the awning of that store, and she's carrying 2 loads of packages of food. She didn't have an umbrella. Obviously, she was waiting for the rain to stop while she was waiting for somebody to take her home. So he stops his car in front of the awning, and he says, "Ma'am, do you need a ride?" She said, "Yeah, but who are you?" He said, "Well, I'm Rabbi Faskowitz, and it looks like you're stuck here in the rain." She says, "Well, I'm not Jewish. My name is Mrs. Flanagan. Would you still take me?" He says, "Yeah, of course. You're a human being, God's creation. I'm a rabbi. I would help anyone. Come, let me help you." And he takes the packages and he puts it in the car. And she comes into the car and they get into a discussion. And she tells him where she lives and he's driving there. And he says, "Ma'am, I hope you don't mind my asking you, but if you're Mrs. Flanagan, obviously you're not Jewish. Why do you shop in a kosher supermarket?" She said, "Rabbi, this food is not for me." She said, "In my apartment building on the 7th floor, there's an elderly couple. They're both invalids. And they can't get out of the house. They have no children. And I know that they only eat kosher food. So once a week, I go out and I shop for them. So all this food is only to that couple." Rabbi Faskowitz says, I am so amazed. I'm doubly happy that I picked you up. I can't believe it." And they get into this discussion, and of course he helps her bring the food. And now he remembers this is the woman who's calling, and he says to her, "Why are you calling me?" She says, "Rabbi, I've been looking for you for the last 3 hours. I didn't know you moved to Queens. That man, he just died. His wife died 3 years ago. They took him to Coney Island Hospital. I don't know what's going to happen to him. I would imagine that he would want to have a Jewish burial. You're the only Jewish person, you're the only Jewish rabbi I know. Is there any way that you could get involved and help that person that I used to bring the food for?" He says, "What's a question? Of course." And he gets off the phone, he calls Coney Island Hospital. Now this was before Amy was involved in the Hebrew Pre-Burial Association. And sure enough, he makes arrangements and he goes to Staten Island and he makes sure that this person has a kosher burial. And he was the only one that was there besides the person that was burying this person. And he gave a hesped for one person. I want to tell you the hesped that he gave. He said to the man who was about to be buried, he said, "Obviously, you must be an olam kosher. You must be a very wonderful, holy person. Because it was only because you ate kashrus that you were zoyche to have a kosher burial. It was only because this woman realized how important kosher food was to you, that she knew who you were, and she was able to make that call to me. Now," he says, "it never occurred to me that which Chazal teach us, mitzvah, goyreres mitzvah. One mitzvah drags along and brings along another mitzvah. Sometimes it could take 15 years. But it was that mitzvah of kashrus that made sure that this person got a kosher burial. And where did he get the kosher burial? He got the kosher burial in Staten Island in the Hebrew Free Burial Association Cemetery. One of the malachim that's involved with Hebrew Free Burial couldn't be here today. His name is Rav Shmuel Plafker. He's the rabbinic authority, the rabbinic advisor, together with Rabbi Zon, and he works for HFBA. And he told me something very interesting. He said, what does the word levaya mean? Normally, if you say you're going to a levaya, it means you're going to a funeral, but that's not what levaya really means. Levaya means to accompany, to come along with somebody else. And I'll tell you something very interesting. This is such an important aspect of life, to be malava someone, not only in their final journey to the Beis Olam, but even in your home. You're not supposed to say goodbye to somebody and let them walk to the door by themselves. Chazal teach us that Avram Avinu, Vayita Eshel, he built an Eshel. So simple meaning is that was a tree, a fruit tree, and many people were able to eat from that tree. Chazal say that Eshel was a hotel, and Avram Avinu, we know, was a big machnas oirach, and he had a hotel where people would be able to come. And Rashi tells us that Eshel stands for three things: Achila, Shtia, and Levoya. That's what a good host is all about. He makes sure that there's food, he makes sure that there's drink, and respectfully accompanies the person when they're about to leave to the door. And it's very interesting. I love what Rabbeinu Bechaya says. Rabbeinu Bechaya says on this pasuk, you know why? You know what a great host is? Somebody who has an Eshel? If you flip around the letters of Eshel, Aleph, Shin, Lamed, it's Shin, Aleph, Lamed, Shaw. The great host is always asking, what can I do for you? How can I be of service for you? How can I help you? That's the simple, the hidden meaning in the word Eshel, which is Shaw. But now listen what the Goyen says, something ingenious. He said, do you know why Avraham Avinu called it Eshel? Because he wanted to change from the way the world was going till then. Oh, the Marishain, how did he sin, him and Chava? With Achila, they ate from the Eitz Hadas. He said, I'm going to serve food in such a holy way that will make up for that Avera of Achila. What was the Avera that Noach did after the table? He drank Shtia. He became drunk. He defiled himself. Avraham Avinu said, I'm going to make sure that the shtia in this home, in this hotel, will be on the highest level. And the people of Sodom, Levoya, they didn't accompany people when they came to Sodom, just the opposite. They tried to kill them, they tried to murder them, they tried to rob them. So those three Averis of Achila, Shtia, and Levoya that were done before Avraham Avinu came about, that's what he was trying to accomplish, to make sure that's what it was all about. And that Levoya is what the Hebrew Free Burial Society is all about. As you heard, it's almost 400 times a year that these burials take place.